बंदे हैं हम उनके, हम पे किसका जोर। यस माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, बंदे हैं हम उनके, हम पे किसका जोर। उम्मीदों का सूरज निकले चारों ओर, इरादे हैं फौलादे। यस माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, इरादे हैं फौलादे, मेहनत हर कदम। अपने हाथों से किस्मत लिखने आज चले हैं हम, आज चले हम, आज चले हम। सो फ्रेंड्स, अवाम एंड प्रेजेंट, गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। हाउ आर यू फ्रेंड्स? आई एम आल्सो फाइन, थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स। हेलो देन, एंड यू ऑल वेलकम टू द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ राइस कमल स्पोकन इंग्लिश सेंटर और बाय मिस्टर विक्रम सर। सो फ्रेंड्स, इट्स वेरी स्पेशल डे फॉर मी दैट आई एम प्रेजेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू। So I would like to thanks to Mr. Vikram sir who has given me this big opportunity for this leading class. So please give a round of applause for Mr. Vikram sir. Friends, today we are going to discuss about a very interesting and wonderful theme. Today our topic is politics. But question is that friends, what is top politics and how this English word has come? Actually, as we all know that the maker as well as father, who is Aristotle, who is called Arastu. So actually, that is the question that what is politics? So now I am going to tell about what is politics. Politics has come from the three words. The first word, what is from the Greek language. The first word, which is politika. It means town and cities. The second word, which is which is means, it means administration. And third word, which is related to the constitutions. So I want to explain about the all types of ideas, all types of works, which is connected to the governing country, town and its fields. That is politics. The group of the people who make some rules and regulations for the citizens, having looked the constitutions. So it is also called politics. So we can say that politics has lots of various types of explanations. But now everybody has some negative thinking that politics is a bad thing. It's a bad word. But friends, for more information, I would like to introduce my two participants, Pooja and Ajit. They will give their own opinion on this topic. So actually, first participant Pooja will give her opinion about the well-experienced leader. So please start.
Thank you, Nandiya, and thank you, sir, for giving this wonderful opportunity. Hello, guys. My name is Pooja Kumari, daughter of Mr. Nenu Gupta, and student of Rajas College Spoken English Center, taught by Mr. Vikram sir. And today I have a very interesting theme, that is experienced leader. When you work, inspire other to do more, learn more, become more, then you are a leader. When a person has perfect knowledge about his subject, has influencing power, motivating power, communicating power, then that's called experienced leader. We all know that nowadays, today's youth are not concentrating, not showing interest to go in politics. That's why their way of communication, way of personality are also not connected. Because of experienced leader, we can create a view that in Hindi it called Durdarshita, that what will happen in future, we can find out. And we also just not think that if a person is there and who has not educational degree, and so he won't have right to go in politics. Our B.R. Ambedkar, our constitution maker, also know the value of experience. That's why he also not mentioned in constitution that for going in politics, you should be educated. You should be. So that's why everywhere experience is appreciated. In my family, my parents are leader. They take care of all the job, household sector, all the things they take care of. And also they take care of our needs. They take care of our studies. They are giving pocket money, and even then they are just saving money for his future crisis. And one day I just asked my father that, Papa, how will you able to manage all the situation in a very better way? At a certain situation also, you can manage in an easy manner. So how you do? Then after, my father told that, beta, I am able because I have lots of experience. That's why I'm able. So friends, we just know that what is the value of experience. And if the same way, if we can say that if our leader will be experienced, then he will be able to do work in a better way, and he will manage at certain situation also in a better manner. And we have seen that in IT sector, in topmost 10 IT companies, person who go to work there, they are just belong to non-IT eras. And they're just working, and no company is successing. Why? Because they're experienced. That's why. That's why we are seeing that too. They are at that company is at a high. So we just not think that if a person is not educated, then after they won't have right to go in politics. And also we just know about that old is gold. Whenever any problem arises, that we are just asked to go to our buddy, that is our elders. Then because we know that what is the value of experience. So in the same way, we can say that experience is everywhere appreciated. And of course, time matter. The degree you obtained before 20 years ago, if you are not accumulating between the related work experience between degree obtained and applying for job, then after your education will not help. Things have been changed too much. And why the work experience matter everywhere? Because it shows you keep up with trend, keep up learning, keep up educating yourself adequately in order to do your job. If I want to say that example, then the biggest example is that about Jayalalitha. When she came into politics, then after she won't have that type of education degree. Even then she is able to motivate people, even then she is able to lead people. Why? Because she has lots of experience. So when she died, then after so many people had cried. So we can say that everywhere experience is needed. If you go to interview also, they are demanding experience leader. So everywhere experience value is more. So thank you guys. I just think that if our leader will be experienced, then our country surely will be developed in a better manner. So thank you guys.
Okay, thank you Pooja. Thanks for explanation. Yes guys. If we talk about the well-experienced leaders, yeah, in this generation, when a society as well as a country, everywhere, well-experienced leaders is much more important. Because according to the situation, according to the place, according to the manifesto ideas, we have to make manifesto plan. So that is the quality of experience. That is the great example of the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi ji, who has a lot of idea and who is the not for in famous in India, in fact, for the world. Every country appreciates his all types of work. So friends, that is the experience. We have to think, we have to use our ideas, we have to our talent, we have according to the situation. That is the experience. Without that experience, I am not thinking that we can develop our society as well as country also. So friends, that is the explanation of the experience. But now, I am going to tell about that my next participant, Ajit ji, who will explain about the well-educated leaders. So please.
Thank you, Nanji. And first of all, I want to thanks to Mr. Vikram sir for giving this a great opportunity to improve myself. And my theme is educated minister. Okay. After explaining educated minister, first of all, I want to say what the value of education. Okay. Education means politeness. Okay. If you get educated at that time, where you have lots of different ideas, innovative ideas. Okay. Not normal ideas. You have different innovative ideas. Everybody knows about Abdul Kalam, K. Sivan, and this type of personality present Indian personality, and because of education, they give something new. Okay. They introduce they just give their 100%. That's why right now we are stand in nuclear power countries. Okay. And you know about politics. Politics means, according to me, politics means politeness. Okay. And politeness comes after getting education. If you have education, if you are well knowledge, then it means you are you have that type of quality to solve any type of problem whenever you face. Okay. Right now in this kind right now in this pandemic, everybody know which type of situation we are facing economically, in education sector, in business sector. Okay. And not in India, all over the world facing this type of problem. But if we have that type of educated personalities, that's why we are able to come out from this type of pandemic. Okay. And one more thing, more important thing is, ministers is the face of a country. Okay, well, actually ministers not work only in India. Lots of times they go in foreign face different type of prime ministers and presidents. At that time, they make different type of deals. Okay, educational deal, in defense deal, business deal, sports deal, agriculture deal. Okay, this type of deals, lots of times they go foreign and crack this type of deals. If just think, if they are not well educated, then how they are able to crack deal in favor of India? Okay, so at that time they always depends on depends on other people's like translator, like their secretaries. Okay, so at that time they are not able to give their own opinion and they are not able to communicate with this type of personalities. Okay, because of hesitation, because of lack of communication. Okay, that's why they are facing different type of problems. Okay, so if our leaders are well educated, that in front of other countries mentality is Indian is a very poor and uneducated, illiterate country. Okay, why? Because of our leaders. Our leaders face. Okay, I mentioned in my point. So when our educated leaders go and track different type of deals and communicate in a better way, at that time in front of that type of leaders, our image of our country will develop and grow. Okay, so because of so if you want to stand in a developed country, then there is a need. Okay, then there is a need of educated ministers. And my partner, my group member Pooja mentioned that what the importance of experience. Just think about it. If experience, educated all together, okay, and if we have that type of personality, then now what will happen in India? Okay, so according to me, and everybody know about Donald Trump, Angela Merkel, okay, Xi Jinping, Shinzo Abe. This type of personality are present in all over the world. They are well educated as well as experienced. Okay, so that's why all these countries, okay, US, Canada, France, Germany, and China, or neighbor China, okay, and Japan, all they stand in a developed countries. Why? Because they have that type of personality. They have that type of educated ministers, okay, and they have that type of innovative ideas. So that's why in this pandemic they are still in grow, okay, they are still developed their countries. Okay, so all this thing will happen, all this thing is happening only because of education and experience. So they actually, according to me, if our leaders are well educated, then they are able to take any strong decision. They are not to go in front of anywhere give opinions of others, other people or other leaders. Okay, at that time there is no need of this. Okay, and actually in India there is a need to take a strong decision and stay on it. Okay, so that's why there is need of education. Okay, lastly I want to say that if there is an education parameter for pune and club type of positions, then there is a need to select and they implement for parameter for leaders also. Okay, and in India what happened, lots of leaders are using different type of in their speech, different type of slang languages they use. Why? Because of illiteracy. They whenever they are facing this type of speech type of organization, at that time they use different type of slangs. It is not good. Okay, it is not good for India. Okay, so that's why education is most important. Okay, and in India all family members are directly depends on leaders. Okay, leaders take decisions for anything, everything. Okay, so that's why there is a need to educate a leader. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Ajit ji, thanks for explanation about the well-educated leaders. Yeah, friends, now the generation which is going on, when everywhere we need the perfect education. By the help of education, we can develop our society as well as country also. It has been called our name, fame, and prosperity up. That is all depend on the better education. So we can say that if you talk about the well experienced, that is an art. And if you talk about the well educated, that is also important, because generation has been changed. If our leaders will be well experienced as well as educated, then surely next generation will take many types of things, which is very important. Actually, we can say that they are the motivated person as well as inspired person. So actually, well education as well as experience, they are the weapon of human daily life. So it is very important. So friends, it was our explanation. I hope you will like this video. And if you want to get any types of notification to this types of video, so please press the bell icon and subscribe our channel. So thank you everyone. Thanks to you.